time, I would like to introduce our Master of Ceremonies, Mr. Lou Vanier. He is the former president of the Motherlode Lions. Lou?
Thank you, Carol. Good evening and welcome to the Eldorado Rose Pageant. It's now my pleasure to introduce the candidates for 2022 Eldorado Rose. Our first candidate is Sherry Phillipson. By the Seropolis International of Placerville, and she's being escorted by her husband, Paul. Now, give her all that applause. Our next candidate is Gay Willard. Gay is sponsored by the Placerville Shakespeare Club, and she's being escorted by Todd White.
Some 40 years ago, the bicentennial year of 1976, a unique salute to the talents of women over 60 years of age was conceived. And that has become a tradition that will hopefully be kept for many more years. Tonight, we have two lovely ladies who qualify. Qualifications are that one must be at least 60 years of age or older, must live in the county for over 10 years, and most importantly, have given her time and energy to noteworthy non-career years of volunteer service. For the competition and for the honor of being selected, she is judged on her knowledge of the history of our county, her costume, and volunteer work that shows her inner beauty. A panel of judges interviewed the ladies Monday morning and made their selection. This outcome is a secret that only they know. There's only one rose be selected tonight. The other lady in the competition will be up for court, which is an honor in itself. Together, during the year, they will attend ribbon cuttings of new businesses and represent our county at numerous functions, always wearing vintage clothing. This pageant has received state and national recognition for the unique salute to the talents and uniqueness of women who refuse to sit into a mold of sedentary life. Let's sit back the rest of the evening and enjoy the selection of our new rose, and thank you so much for coming.
Okay, thank you, Carol. Okay, our 2021 rose, Colleen Moore, didn't start her year until last September due to the COVID. The pageant was canceled in 2020. The fair was also canceled in 2021, but the Eldorado Rose directors decided to hold the competition anyway, as we had four ladies vying for the Eldorado Rose. The pageant was held at the American Legion Hall, Post 119. Colleen here ends with this pageant. Colleen will tell you a little bit about her time and introduce her four ladies. Colleen?
Disposal dump, I call it the dump, and they built a new platform, and they call it like a canvas, and it's just a big slab of concrete. But anyway, they're going to do their recycling. They're really getting into recycling, so they were recycling their materials. And what they had there was this machine that was just huge, and they called it the transfer, and the guys were going up and down in it. So I walked over and said, can I have a ride? And they let me ride in it. I went in my long dress and everything. I'm climbing up into this big machine. I took it all the way to the top, and we came down, and it was a lot of fun. I enjoyed it. So that was my favorite one. And then we went to one where I had, they had a lot of raffles at these events that we went to. And I always, you know, bought a few tickets, and this time I won. I won a remote control door, a screen door for our sliding glass door. Anyway, so that was kind of exciting too. Then we went on a field trip. This wasn't really a Rose event. I mean, event where we cut ribbon. This was just where all the girls all got together, and we went to a bonsai. Did I say it right?
Yeah.
Bonsai. Dr. Claudia. Anyway, because we learned how to cut bonsai trees down, and this band lectured gave us a lecture, and it was really interesting. And then he gave us all a free Japanese iris, I guess it was. So that was a lot of fun. But anyway, in the meantime, I just wanted to thank some people that helped me get to be a Rose. And that one number one person is Carol Mueller. I have to thank her. She did quite a lot to get me to become a Rose, and she's still my right hand. I mean, I really look to her for a lot of things. I need to really thank her, and I owe her some hay. I think that's probably why she worked so hard, because I promised I'd buy her some hay for her cows if I won. And I haven't paid it back with the hay yet, so anyway. And the other people that I would like to thank would be my husband, for one. He had to put up with all of the balls and the waltz lessons and waiting around for me, so I have to thank you one. And also, there was one event that really touched me. I forgot to mention that one. It's the Big Brothers and Big Sisters. They moved their building from where they were up onto Main Street. And they had a really nice building. And I talked to the people that are running it. And I got to learn a lot about the Big Sisters, Big Brothers program, which is, they do take volunteers. So I was thinking of giving them a call. I'd like to introduce my court also. I forgot about that. Ellen Fisher. Right there. Dave Miller over there. And Coco DiCarlo to Lincoln.
I'd like to introduce her husband, Gary, who's going to give her her escort for her final walk. Are you ready for some entertainment?
Yes.
So am I. First, we're going to have Carol Caruso.
Thank you.
pioneering was usually initiated by men, they were by no means the only ones engaged in that endeavor. Many single men and married men acting as temporary bachelors, seduced by the thought of rich land and loaves, traveled west. But settlement was often contingent on the making and maintaining of families there. Thousands of women therefore trudged overland trail after 1840, when the great westward migration took off. Most of these women were married, and while some were forced to take the move, others insisted on accompanying their men, for they were determined to maintain family unity despite the great potential risk to their health and safety. Some of the single women married on the trip, or soon thereafter, while numerous married women were widowed. Many of these female pioneers had to deal with the rigors of the journey while pregnant or while caring for young children. Taken away from civilization, they were determined to take civilization with them. While the journey was liberating for a few, most battled constant challenges to their feminine and domestic identities. And now we're going to hear from some of those ladies who made the trip.
Hi, y'all. I'm Marriott Foster Cummings, and I'm married to William Cummings. And we were married in 1852, and I was 25 years old, and we crossed the plains to California. April 17th, this is from my diary. April 17th, 1852, I got up and put on a suit of short clothes, bloomers they call them, to avoid the mud. Got out and walked, and passing one house, the women came out and laughed at me. Or my dress. I did not ask which, but found it much more convenient for traveling than the long one. Bloomers. Another excerpt from my diary. April 19, 1852 came to the village of Lafayette. The place was small and well enough, I presume, but I was prejudiced by what I saw before I came to it. The road was somewhat muddy, and so it had been turned through the unfenced resting place of the dead. All along by the road were sunken graves covered with the footprints of animals that roamed all over them at will. It looked so unfeeding, inhuman in the habitats, to live in plain sight of such things, that I could not think the village was pleasant.
Thomas Sawyer on April 25th in 1852, and I was 21 years old. We traveled by wagon train to... We traveled by wagon train to California in Maine. It was pronounced that way. On May 20, this is from my diary. On May 26, 1852, a large party upon the Indians passed us in the morning and going to the hunting grounds at the Buffalo. And this afternoon we met them returning. They had met a party of Sioux, and the result was a battle which took place. The Sioux had whipped them, killing and scalping two of them. The Pawnees were angry and badly injured. I met some of the ladies that had seen the battle, and they said they were almost scared to death themselves. We came upon the battle that had been fought, and out of curiosity, Mr. Sawyer and I drove off the road a short distance to see one of the Indians that had been killed. Oh, it was awful. It was four or five arrows sticking out of the body and it just felt. It was bloody and just awful. I really wish I hadn't done it. I've been blue ever since then.
Well, hello, everyone. My name is Catherine Hahn, and I'm a young, newly married woman. Early in January of 1849, we first thought about immigrating to California. There was a period of national hard times, and we were financially involved in our business interests near Clinton, Iowa. I longed to go to the new El Dorado and pick up enough gold with which I could return to Iowa and pay off all those debts. It was more than 3 months before we were thoroughly equipped, and then on April 24th, 1849, we left our comfortable homes and the uncomfortable creditors for the uncertain and dangerous trip. Our new homes were canvas covered schooners. Oxen were the preferred animals to pull those wagons. Finally, after weeks of travel, the mountains of the West came into view. This was the land of the buffalo. We came upon a herd, and two of the buffalo were shot, and the humps and the tongue furnished us with some fresh meat, wonderful meals. Buffalo chips were gathered by everyone, and when they were dry, they were used as fuel. During the day, we women folk, we had to visit each other from wagon to wagon, having cholera, and was present at the time on the plains, but we were fortunate and not a single one of our party came down with cholera. Our only death on the journey occurred in the desert. Mrs. Lamore was a pregnant lady. She got sick after childbirth, and she and the child died. So we halted for a day on our journey so we could bury her in the infant. In this weird, lonely spot, God's footstool away, apparently everywhere and everybody. We reached Sacramento on November 4, 1849, just 6 months and 10 days after leaving Clinton. We were all in very good condition. Thank you.
At this time, I'd like to present the Gold Rush Barbershop Chorus.
Across the water. I don't know why you just do this to me. You never seem to want my romancing. The only time you hold me is when we're dancing. I don't know why I love you like I do. I don't know why I just do this to you. I don't know why I love you like I do. Oh, I don't know why I just do like you. I don't know why you thrill me like you do. I don't know why you just do. You never seem to want my romancing. The only time you hold me is when we're dancing. I don't know why I love you like I do. I don't know why I just do. The way I love you, the way I do.
Present at this time the past Eldorado Roses. Will our past Eldorado Roses please stand? Let's give them a big hand. Please remain standing. Now, will the ladies of the court please stand?
Volunteer, a classroom volunteer, and the list goes on and on. If you really want to know everything, if the Mountain Democrat ran everybody's references on Monday, and it's just amazing. I don't know how she has time for anything else. Sherry is wearing a Pioneer Prairie dress circa 1848 to 1900. This is a reproduction of what a woman would have worn on a wagon train or a farmer's wife. The dress is all cotton. Her apron is also cotton. She has a straw hat. Homemade purse was made from her dress fabric. All underlings are also cotton, and she is wearing lace-up boots. Thank you, Sherry. Our next lady is Gay Willard. Gay is a widow with a son and a daughter, one granddaughter, two grandsons, two great-granddaughters, and a brand-new great-grandson. Gay has been a county resident since moving here in 1980. She jumped right into volunteering. She has participated in the 4-H program. She has served on the fair board. She has volunteered on various events held during the fair. If there's a volunteer position that needs to be filled, she's always ready to lend a hand. Gay is wearing an all-antique original ensemble circa 1905. Silk shirtwaist walking skirt and blouse. The skirt is a light blue silk. The blouse is a rust-colored silk bécine. The hat is a cream cotton picot with several 120-year-old hat pins. She has a linen parasol. The purse is a German silver frame, antique lace-up pumps, cotton hose, rose and gold jewelry and crocheted gloves. Thank you, Gay.
It's my privilege to introduce to you Karen Feathers, president of the Old Rock County Fair Board of Directors. So she wasn't able to make it to practice yesterday, so we get to pick on each other. She says, well, Lou, you're going to do this. Okay.
That's how that works.
That's how this works. I follow instructions really well. Carol will be presenting the trophy for the most authentic costume, and it goes to... Gay Willard. The second trophy is for the best reproduction costume, and it goes to Sherry Phillipson. Now it's time to announce the 2022 Eldorado Rose. Karen will present her with the trophy. Sherry Phillipson. Meanwhile, ladies. Song, When You're Smiling, and I'm told it is in your program.